face with your derpy car. That's that derpy face with the derpy car.
What's up, Life Right Nation?
What's up, Life Right Nation?
And welcome to NOLA Motorsports.
You like it?
Dude, it's so much fun.
You freaking nailed it. You freaking nailed it.
So rowdy.
Yeah.
This car is so, dude, the supercharger makes all the difference in the world.
Isn't it cool?
So yeah. East Coast supercharging, whereas before, like second gear had power, but you had to use a lot more clutch kicks and you had to be a lot more aggressive with the throttle because you really didn't have the power you needed to do what you wanted to do. Dude, with this, like you just, I'm not even in the throttle, I'm just feathering it.
You're just playing with it.
Oh God, it's f***ing beautiful. It's perfect.
Ah. And then when we get to a bigger track, you can start doing that in third gear.
Woo-hoo. So real quick, one of probably the coolest builds on this entire drift week is what you see behind me. And the reason it's so rad is because it's extremely deceiving. This is not at all what it appears to be.
It appears to be a truck.
All right, so this is Dustin Hash. He's the one that's drifting this bad boy around the entire track. Why is this unique?
It's the only truck out here.
Aaron doesn't allow trucks. Lone Star Drift, Aaron does not allow trucks. He just doesn't allow them. They don't work, but this one is quite unique.
It works, but why?
It's all C5 underneath every bit of it.
C5 Dude, meaning it's a Corvette.
It's a Corvette, essentially, underneath here with just this rad, rusty truck body slapped on top, and you've turned it into like a rowdy as drift car.
It does pretty well.
So I'm doing a little bit of work to the car and I see the cover for the cabin air filter's off. So I decide to check it. And yeah, this is what our cabin air filter looks like. I mean, I guess it's doing a good job because the other side looks pretty good, but Jesus, this has got to be original 2006 freaking cabin air filter. And it's like collapsed. Like, look at that. It's not even flat anymore. That's gross. So I guess I know what the next thing I'm buying for this is, because that's disgusting. So to show you the dedication that some of these guys are going through, as you can see here, we have an E36 BMW with an engine delete kit. It looks like they have a transmission delete kit as well. The transmission is over there where it does not do anything for the car. But if you look down here, here's a pile of rods and bearings. I'd assume he spun the bearings in the motor and it is now trash, but but I look over here and I see this.
Yeah.
What is going on?
Rod knock yesterday.
So you spun, okay, so it's spun bearings
and went and found a crank at the junkyard.
So you had to pull a crank at a junkyard? So
yeah,
you had to go?
Pulled a short block and then put a new crank and rods in.
Literally in at the track in the parking lot. No big deal.
Oh!
let some friends drive the Corvette, get an impression. Zach, my buddy True Taylor, he's driven 240s. We've shared 240s, 350Zs. He's got a nitrous 350Z and now a JZX 100 that he blew up instantly yesterday. So we're gonna let them take the vet for a ride. Stay off rev limiter. Don't go into the ditch if you go off. I'm sure he'll be asleep by the time we get back. If he can get in the car. So the seat is fixed. The seat is fixed and it's really hard to get in. I can pull the roof off.
I got it.
You got it?
I got it.
What are you? You're letting them drive your car, Brittany.
Technically, you're letting them drive my car.
This thing's fantastic.
It's a cheater car, isn't it?
You can't do. You gotta be in third, man.
You can do third.
I just want to see him get out now.
Hey, Zach's smart. He took his helmet off first.
I don't think I can get my helmet off.
Go run some errands in that.
Freaking third gear roasted him. Dude.
Why you got a smirk on your face, Brittany?
Because if you guys watched the last video, you're aware that at the very end, Kevin surprised me by visiting family friends I haven't seen in like 15 years. And I found out that my mom was in New Orleans, which means, of course, that my mom gets to go on the drift car.
I apologize already for my sailor mouth.
All right, babe, give her a ride. Hey, shake and bake.
Shake and bake.
Shake and bake.
Shake and bake means that we're gonna go as fast as possible and wreck into everything that we see.
I can hear her mom screaming again. Yeah, I saw
I
you nail. I saw. Was that better, Mom? I heard you screaming all the way at the corner after you made that last one. I heard her screaming. Woo! I could hear her.
We're doing a challenge right now. It is the parking challenge. It's way more fun than you think, especially in someone else's car. Zach let us borrow his car, and it's, I mean, like, in your own car, it's fun, but in somebody else's car, like, you don't care. So we just basically build a box out of these tires. You got to come in here, drift in, and park the thing sideways as close to this set of barriers as possible, and then as close to those as possible. So.
Or you're at least going to attempt to do that. So this is our first parking area.
Oh, God.
Who's next? Drive, go, 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 Brittany. No, just don't hit the crowd.
Well, okay.
Do your best.
Does the seat move?
No, just go.
I can't reach the pedals.
She can't even see out of the door. Good job. All right, she's too short for that.
I'm too short.
We can let you try the Corvette. Here you go. Brittany's wasn't fair. She couldn't reach the pedals because she's too tiny. But you know, it wouldn't have helped if Kevin was doing it, because he couldn't reach the pedals either.
Guys, just so you can see here, Colette was way smarter than me, and she brought her own seats to make a difference.
How do I go forward?
You don't.
You don't go
That's
forward.
That's my point. Oh, you can't reach the freaking pedals.
You can do it.
No, I can't.
You want to sit on my lap?
Just for the record, this is me sitting up.
Sit in someone's lap.
That's what Adam said.
Stay in it. Come on, come on, come on.
It's so hard.
No time to worry about the past. Await the future to come at last. This time tomorrow, I will be gone. A fading memory forever.
That's pretty good.
I wanna wake up without sorrow. I wanna step out in a world that's brighter. We are the people of tomorrow. We stand together, raise our hands up.
Four.
start that over.
She'll keep you out of the wall and not hit another car or anything.
I was gonna try to hit other cars, but no.
So Brittany decided the car wasn't low enough, so she lowered it while driving, and
there's too much ass in the car.
Yeah. Jeez. Good job, Brittany.
I don't know if a jack would. Jack probably would work.
We'll probably get a jack in there. We can get a jack underneath it and then just walk it back. But the jack legs, it's not going to roll that way. Is the problem?
Do you have a knuckle?
I have a knuckle.
We have a knuckle.
Oh, okay.
Like, we can replace it. I just want to get it off track.
So Brittany was going too ham. She dropped a tire inside the curb and literally ripped the knuckle off.
The front left dipped and then the inside.
It just went.
Yeah. Knocked it out.
Yeah, that's why I'm scared of those corners.
Yeah, she has no holes barred. No holes barred? Yeah.
Did you get up close?
No, yeah, not yet. She, what are you going to do about that fender?
Tie it back on.
So... there you can see the knuckle is broken. Hopefully nothing else is broken, but it all looks okay. No, it's just the knuckle. Hey, look. Hey, come make a derpy face with your derpy car. It's that derpy face with the derpy car. So, sway bar's okay, tie rod's okay.
So, right there.
That piece is broken.
That is not supposed to be broken.
If you can see where your wheel hit. Oh, nice. So, if you hit a curb, well.
You have to replace a knuckle.
Behind door number one, the contestant has a two-piece knuckle.
Anyways, okay. So this was our knuckle, essentially. As you can see, so to get the amount of angle that we generally need without hitting the tie rod, because your tie rod bolts here and swings in right here, you can see the knuckles are shaved down, which gives you a lot of angle without risk of hitting or bending your tie rod. But as you can see, it also creates this weak point so that if you hit things that you're not supposed to hit, that's your failure point. Not the end of the world. Looking at it though, it looks like the knuckle is all that we broke. Is got the knuckle swapped out on the Corvette, yay, and we were able to eyeball alignment just in time to drive all the way from New Orleans to Mid Pond Raceway.
Six and a half hours in the Corvette in that race seat. Oof.
Bad news is we have to go drifting tomorrow morning again.
That's bad news.
It's good news because I'm excited because I like drifting, but it's bad news because I'm exhausted. So freaking tired.
Most people, we were just chatting on the way down here, most people are at over 4,000 to 4,500 miles so far for the trip, like getting to Tucson and then from Tucson to where we're at now.
We drive a lot in our lifestyle, but this is a whole different world so far. When we're not traveling, we're driving or working on the car. Anyways, the point is, it's getting tiring, but I do have to give a huge shout out to Jill Hull for helping us swap the knuckle on the Corvette out as quickly as he did, because if it had been just us, it would have taken us a lot longer and this drive would have sucked a lot more.
Yeah.
So, but Corvette's back together. We're driving at Mid Pond first thing in the morning and it's going to be freaking awesome. Guys, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. You can find all your Lite Brite Nation merch at LiteBriteStudios.com. All your Lite Brite Nation decals at PixelDecals.com. Guys, we love you so much. We'll see you next time.
Bye, guys.
Mwah. Good night. I'm going to bed. The song is getting hot in here. So for those of you that watched the last video, if you'll remember that giant bag of churro nuggets that Kevin was absolutely obsessed with, well, he left it opened in the passenger floorboard while we went drifting. And would you just look at this beautiful mess that I get to clean up now. Look, it's all underneath the seats.